Hello everyone, I hope you are doing well. I'm sure most of you in the community know of Mr. Neil Ripsky. He's the founder of Red Jade Martial Arts, based in Alberta, Canada, and a very good friend of mine. I met him in person a few years ago, and I was really impressed by his knowledge and practice in martial arts, as well as his approach to teaching. A few days ago, Mr. Ripsky's studio was broken into and all his martial art weapons were stolen, including priceless items such as his Red Jade sword, which inspired the name of his school, along with the spear and the Bagua broadsword, both of which his father had handcrafted for him. Mr. Ripsky has filed a police complaint and the investigation is ongoing. I'm positive he will get justice soon. Ms. Ripsky, you are strong and I'm sure you will come out even stronger from this incident. Please continue your good work as always. To the audience and the community members, in case you were not aware already, Mr. Ripsky teaches many martial art styles, most notably the 18 Luohan Palm and the Drunken Fist. I recommend you all reach out to him for more details about his classes as well as seminars around the world. His website and social media links are in the description. I'm sure you will enjoy learning from him. It's still very cold in Montreal, and we have had comparatively a lot more snow this winter. But since spring is coming, many of you may have been experiencing internal energy rising feelings and sensations. If so, it is a good sign since it indicates that you are sensitive to energy change. It is so interesting to see that people can sense seasonal change based on their energetic experiences. The ancient Chinese believed that the human body reflects the nature around it. Human beings should follow seasonal changes in order to maintain good health. For example, you should practice more stretching exercises during early spring as the rising energy will help to enhance your flexibility. Also, stretching movements or any type of upward and expanding motion will help to strengthen your energy. I have introduced this topic before, so I'd like to remind you to practice more stretching exercises from now on. Furthermore, according to the five element theory, the spring season is associated with the wood element. And wood represents growth, extension, flexibility, and so on. Spring also represents the beginning of a new life. A very positive sign indeed. So, I hope you will use this opportunity to improve your practice. As for Dao Yi, we are in the process of creating the Dao Yi online magazine. We want to make sure the readers will have the best overall experience with the magazine. To ensure the quality of each article, we are in the process of planning a publication review committee. So, if you have experience with reviewing publications, please let us know. Today, I'd like to introduce Shen Fa or Body Method, an important Xing Yi topic. Shen Fa is the common topic in any martial art style, no matter internal or external. Also, each style has its unique Shen Fa, even though they may share some common practices. This makes the Shen Fa one of the distinguishing characteristics of any style. In this video, I will focus on Xing Yi Shen Fa and I will save other styles for the future. Furthermore, since Shen Fa is a deep topic, it is impossible to comprehensively explain it in one video. So, I will post follow-up videos for specific topics in the near future, hopefully in increasing order of complexity so that you can incorporate them into your practice as and when they get released. Please give me more time and I will introduce many more interesting topics. It is my passion and a great honor to share my knowledge with you, and it is free. Topics covered in today's video include: first, 身体 in classical Chinese; second, 身法; third, importance of 身法; fourth, relationships between 身法 and power; fifth, misperceptions of 身法; sixth, demonstration; and seventh, takeaways. So, without any further ado, let's get started. Topic 1. 身体 in classical Chinese. The term 身体 consists of two characters that means body in classical Chinese. It is a very common term and is a commonly used term even today in China, since 身体 can mean many things such as body, health, and so on. Most people think the term 身体 only means the body. However, this is a major misconception, as in the old times. It had a different meaning. If you read classical Chinese or 文言文, 身 and 体 mean two totally different things. Actually, 身 means the torso, while 体 means the limbs. This is why in modern Chinese, people usually do not distinguish between 身 and 体. The combination term 身体 includes both 身 and 体, or torso and limbs, as used in ancient times. We can see this linguistic phenomenon everywhere. The problem that arises is that it becomes very hard to express a meaning precisely, which actually can create certain confusion and should be avoided at all costs. Now, I'd like to talk about the concept of the Shen in more detail. In Confucianism, Shen is closely associated with another important concept, Xin or mind. Even though Confucianism emphasizes the cultivation of Xin or mind, it in no way implies you can ignore the cultivation of Shen or body. For example, 内外交养以心为主, or mutual cultivation of internal and external of oneself and focus on mind, is one of the guiding principles in Confucianism. The words internal and external in this context mean internal and external approaches. Confucianism implies that the internal approach will impact the external appearance, while the external approach will lead to internal change. This integration of internal and external, or body and mind, built a strong foundation for further development of self-cultivation in Neo-Confucianism. For example, Confucianism promotes the concept of Ren and Li, or benevolence and manners, which is the result of the integration of the internal approach and the external approach. Ren, or benevolence, is the result of internal cultivation, while Li, or manner, is the result of external cultivation. So, mind and body are inseparable according to Confucianism. This is a very interesting topic, but in the interest of time, let's move on to the main topic for today. Topic 2. 身法. In the previous topic, I explained 身. So, what is 法? 法语 Chinese language also has multiple meanings such as law, regulation, method, solution, and so on. Also, 法 is a very common term used in martial arts and Shudo practice. In this context, it means method. So, the term 身法 means body method. Unfortunately,Many practitioners, including some martial art teachers, believe 身法 to be the whole body movement, including both torso and limbs, which is wrong. Like I have mentioned in a prior topic, 身法 only means the body method, and more specifically, it includes only the movements of the torso and does not include movements of the limbs.Chinese martial art terminology contains specific terms for expressing movements performed by different body parts. For example, the training method of a torso is called 身法 or body method. The training method of a stepping is called 步法. The training method of a hand is called 手法. The training method of elbow is called 肘法. Bottom line,身法 is the 身法, not to be confused with 步法 or 手法 or 肘法. Furthermore, 身 in classical Chinese also means root, essence, and core, which implies the important part of a subject. In martial art practice, 身法 is the practice of body movement, which is the most important mechanism inpower generation. So, 身法 or body method actually means the training method of the torso. Going forward, you should ensure that whenever you talk about the 身法, you only mean movements of the torso and not other part of the body. Again, only 身法 is 身法. Bear in mind,身法 is used to describe the body moving method, which makes it a dynamic concept and not a static one, such as for stance training. I recommend you check out my video on the Xing Yi 24 method, in which I have introduced the Xing Yi 3T stance practice with a focus on the static approach. Link is in the description. So, 身法 is dynamic.And has to be practiced and demonstrated in a movement. So, how important is 身法? This brings us to the next topic. Topic 3, importance of 身法. In 形意, 身法 is the spirit of the entire style. No matter how fancy your movements, if you lack the right 身法,your practice will go nowhere. 身法 is also one of the key factors that distinguish one branch of 形意 from another. In other words, different branches of 形意 actually apply to different 身法. Of course, movements of the torso do not occur in vacuum, unless you are actually in space.Any martial movement involving the torso also involves other body parts, especially the limbs. So, the coordination between the body and the limbs is the key aspect in martial art practice. Unfortunately, many Xing Yi practitioners overemphasize the practice of the limbs but pay insufficient attention to 身法.This is exactly why many of them suffer from poor coordination between the body and the limbs. The body is not able to act in unison with the limbs, creating a disadvantageous situation for them in practice. Slow body movement caused by poor 身法 practice reduces the speed of the limbs.This is why I always tell my students to first prioritize 身法 practice. The limbs will follow the progress of the body movements, and eventually both shen and ti, or body and the limbs, will develop in sync. Any discussion of shen fa would be incomplete without the mention of dan tian. In the internal cells, both lower dan tian and the middle dan tian are parts of the body, considered to be the source of power in martial art practice. Shen fa involves dan tian practice, especially the lower dan tian area, which is the key source of internal power in martial practice. Check out my prior video introducing and explaining dan tian in the context of martial arts as well as xiu dao. Link is in the description. Going forward, you should pay close attention to body movements and not limit your focus to the limbs. In martial art practice, great internal power is the ultimate objective, which is the result of force and speed. Xing Yi is the Fa Jin oriented style, and the Fa Jin or power training is critical to Xing Yi practice. Xing Yi practice without power will only be considered a primitive level of practice. So, what is the relationship between Shen Fa and power? That brings us to the next topic. Topic 4. Relationships between Shen Fa and power. Shen Fa and power have the closest relationship in terms of martial power generation. In Xing Yi practice, if your martial power is not strong enough, then you should look into your body training method to correct that situation. As I have mentioned in prior sections, the difference in speed between the body and the limbs slows down the overall speed. Lack of coordination between body movements and the limb movements hinders the martial force, affecting martial power generation, which is the result of martial force and speed. Long story short, Shen Fa is the foundation of strong power execution or Fa Jin, and Fa Jin is the litmus test of correct Shen Fa. Fa Jin practice is the integration of Shen Fa and power practice. Many practitioners, upon realizing that their Xing Yi power generation is insufficient, resort to exaggerated limb movements to compensate for lack of power. This is especially noticeable among Xing Yi practitioners that are influenced by modern wushu practice. For example, you may have noticed some practitioners pretend to accumulate energy by executing pretentious movements. That may be okay according to modern wushu, but I have to say that is not good Xing Yi at all. Xing Yi practice does not involve exaggerating one movement in a demonstration by pretending to accumulate strength. Any practice rooted in Taoist practice should be natural, not pretentious. In the old days, practitioners in Tianjin often said, "Dong shou jian xiang." Dong means to move, shou means hand, jian means to show, xiang means sound. Put together, it translates, "As long as your hand moves, there's a sound." Just like this. Does not mean the sound of the hand, it's the sound of the body. Or sound made by body movement without any preparation and energy accumulation time. In other words, at an advanced level, you should be able to execute Fa Jin without preparation, which is the result of Shen Fa practice. In this video, I will not introduce the specific practice of Shen Fa, but only introduce some of its important concepts. I will introduce some specific Xing Yi Shen Fa training method in the future. However, you can watch the demonstration section of many of my Xing Yi related videos on this channel. There are many 身法 demonstrations, and you use them as reference material for your practice. Let me replay a small clip from a prior video. Hello, I'd like to demonstrate one single exercise from Xue Dian's Xiang Xing Shu practice, a variation of Xue Dian's style Xing Yi. This exercise is used to demonstrate to practice the Tun Tu technique and the principle. Okay, so you can keep your leg open at just wider, a little bit than the shoulder width. Then one palm move under, then strike, then keep moving, then keep moving. Important part is the coordination between the shoulder and the palm. One, two. Okay, you can put the force. Okay, or just do that slowly without force. So, given that Shen Fa is a popular topic, is it well understood in the community and totally free of misperceptions? Of course not. Which brings us to the next topic. Topic 5. Misperceptions of Shen Fa. As I have mentioned in the past, and I will continue to do so in the future, clarification of misperceptions can have a great learning benefit, since it can help a practitioner identify what to avoid and how to avoid it. There are probably more misperceptions about Shen Fa than the amount of tea in my basement. But in today's video, I've introduced two of the most common ones, and hopefully they will benefit your practice. They are, first, Shen Fa Bu Fa Hun Tan, confusion between Bu Fa and Shen Fa, and Shen Fa Yao Ruan. First, Shen Fa Bu Fa Hun Tan, translation, confusion between Bu Fa and Shen Fa, or stepping method and body method. Many practitioners often perceive fast stepping or fast Bu Fa to be Shen Fa practice. In reality, even though Bu Fa and Shen Fa are closely related, they are totally different and cannot replace each other. Correct Xing Yi practice involves the coordination between Bu Fa and Shen Fa. Typically, Shen Fa controls Bu Fa or Bu Fa serves Shen Fa. Of course, there are exceptions. Sometimes, Bu Fa determines Shen Fa. For example, when you move fast in order to create momentum, Shen Fa follows Bu Fa at such a moment. Regardless, Shen Fa and Bu Fa are always different practices. Furthermore, as I mentioned before, Shen Fa and Bu Fa are related, but a relationship alone can never imply replaceability. This is a very important aspect of logic, and you should always remember this point in differentiating between similar and closely related martial practices to avoid unnecessary confusion. Again, the right methodology is the key, and all serious practitioners should pay attention to it. Conclusion: fast stepping, no matter how fast, will always be Bu Fa or stepping method. It will never be Shen Fa. Second, Shen Fa Yao Ruan. Translation: Shen Fa practice should be soft. This is another very common mistake. Many practitioners perceive softness to be Shen Fa practice. Well, as I mentioned before, the objective of a Shen Fa practice is to develop power execution or Fa Jin. To reach that result, the body should not only be soft, but more importantly, flexible. Flexibility is the prerequisite of a Shen Fa practice. Softness alone will make your martial structure hollow. Softness alone is just floppiness. To ensure the correct Shen Fa for developing martial power, The body should adjust its strength level based on the movement. However, at the exactly instant of the power release, the body structure should be solidified and tensified, which is the state of being flexible yet strong and fast. So, softness by itself will not provide this result. Softness without flexibility is a very common mistake in the internal styles of martial arts and should be avoided at all costs. Topic 6, demonstration. Today, I'd like to demonstrate a shenfa method. You can copy this movement and with time, you will improve your xingyi shenfa practice. I'd like to remind you that shenfa is very often subtle. However, in order to demonstrate shenfa, I will make the movement more obvious. The name of this movement is hu pu or tiger pushing. Very often, people practice hu pu without any shenfa, which is totally wrong. Without proper shenfa, hu pu is not a tiger pushing. It's just a dead tiger. Not a deadly tiger, but a dead tiger. By the way, you must have definitely come across many dead tiger-like practice in the xingyi community. Maybe that's why the number of real tigers is decreasing nowadays. Let me demonstrate a xingyi tiger pushing exercise which emphasizes on the shenfa practice. You can start from here. 1, 2. 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. Topic 7, takeaways. First, according to classical Chinese, shen means the body and the ti means the limbs. Second, shenfa or body method is the training method for the torso. It is not to be confused with the bufa or shoufa or zhoufa. Third, shenfa is the spirit of xingyi. Shenfa is critical to developing coordination between the body and the limbs. Fourth, different branches of xingyi utilize different shenfa. Fifth, shenfa is the foundation for fajin, and fajin is the litmus test of shenfa. 6. Two common misperceptions of shenfa are, first, shenfa bufa huntan, confusion between shenfa and bufa. Second, shenfa yao ruan, or shenfa practice should be soft. Remember, both of these are misperceptions and should be avoided. Make sure to check out the demonstration section to get a good idea of how to practice shenfa using the hu pu or tiger pushing movements. That brings us to the end of today's video. I recommend you all reach out to Mr. Neil Ripsky for information about his classes and seminars on 18 Luohan Palm and the Drunken Fist, or support him in any way you can. Thanks for watching, see you next time, and enjoy your shenfa practice.